'cause that's the kind of gal
I'm. The thing that I miss the most right now is live theater. There is something about putting a show together with an incredible cast of humans and a creative team for everything that goes into making a show. The sets, the costumes, the props, the lighting, the stage, opening night. It's just so magical, and I miss performing at Gallery Players. I miss watching shows at Gallery Players. I miss my Gallery Players family. And we are so excited for the day that Gallery Players can open their doors again and we can get back to live theater.
I think for me, my favorite thing about it, about the situation, is that I've had this extended visit with my mom near the end of her time. And here I am, older myself. And we are sitting in the evenings now. And we are sharing on my tablet. I pulled up the 1967 Foresight Saga, which absolutely had a tremendous effect on me when I was a kid, and I watched with my mom at that time. It was the first big Masterpiece Theater miniseries. It was the granddaddy of all the great ones, Upstairs, Downstairs, Downtown. All that came from this great series, The Foresight Saga, from 1967 on the BBC. So I'm having a tremendous deja vu with my mom watching this. And it's just a masterpiece of ensemble acting. And I realize as I watch it that the 12-year-old me was so influenced by it and wanted nothing more than to just be an actor afterwards. So do yourself a favor. Go on YouTube and watch it in glorious black and white. You will never forget it. That's my gift to you.
Quarantine. I decided I was not going to let quarantine get in the way of fabulous hair, so I took matters into my own hands. And by matters, I mean a pair of IKEA scissors I picked up when I first moved to New York about 12 years ago, the kind you get in a pack of three. So I got to work carefully, trimming a little here, a little there, wait for it to dry. Curly hair takes forever to dry. It looks exactly the same as before. Well, they say first do no harm. That night I went to bed and counted all the money I could save if I never set foot in a hair salon again. Hundreds of dollars, thousands of dollars. I could be a millionaire.
The thing that has impacted me the most during this time is seeing artists come together. Not physically, of course, but seeing artists support each other, create together, and inspire one another. The videos of people singing and dancing and acting from their homes has been just lovely. I think right now, more than ever, the world needs more art, more theater. So thank you, artists, for still creating.
All those days watching through the window, all those years outside looking in, all that time never even knowing just how blind I've been.
Now, well, during my quarantine, I've been keeping busy and staying healthy. I hope you guys are too. But when I'm not doing video auditions and virtual performances, I love to bake, ride my bike, I ride it every single day, and have fun with my family.
So clear, it's where I'm meant to be. And at last I see the light, and it's like the fog has lifted. And at last I see.
And the world has somehow
I just want to say that I miss my gallery player's family very much, and I can't wait until we can make magic in the theater together again. I think you're all extra special.
Round 2. 7 p.m. after a long, hard day of Zoom calls, analyzing my hair in the monitor. 7 p.m. Everyone's clapping outside. This was going to be fabulous. I grab my IKEA scissors and get to work. Wait for it to dry. Now, curly hair is like a pool toy. Until it fully inflates, you don't know if you have a rainbow unicorn or a deranged monster. I had a deranged monster. One side was longer than the other, there were pieces sticking up, and now it was too short to put in a ponytail. That night I went to bed and dreamt of being a millionaire with fabulous hair.
I'm one of those people that love to be face-to-face with people, playing games, having good conversations, but now we can't because of coronavirus, and I got really upset. But now I actually understand about Rapunzel and Tangled because she was quarantined, and you might not know this, in Corona. That was the village. That was what it was called. And I thought, whoa, what a coincidence. That it's very funny. Quarantined in Corona. But she had a prince to come save her, but we don't have anyone to save us. But if we all stay home and everything, we will be just okay. I hope everyone is safe, and everyone wash your hands, use hand sanitizers, and I hope everyone is gonna be good. Bye!
Hey, what you doing there, Lauren?
Knitting a shawl.
Why are you doing that?
Because I don't have enough shawls.
Hi, I'm Heather Hurst. I had the wonderful good fortune to get to play Grace Farrell in Gallery's production of Annie a few years ago. And I gotta say that since all this COVID-19 quarantine stuff has really set in, that I've been really fortunate, my family's been really fortunate. My job was remote to begin with, and, you know, knock on wood, has kept going. But what is really missing from my life these days is Brooklyn, and is the neighborhood that I share with gallery players. We came up to take care of some vulnerable family members in Maine, and while it's lovely, Maine is not New York City. So I miss home each day. I miss the local haunts. I miss being able to say I live 5 blocks from one of my favorite theaters, and I certainly miss getting to go there. But we are counting our blessings every day, and can't wait to be back and see my next show there. So wishing you all well, and thanks. Cheers.
I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. My own planets and stars are glowing. No one notices anything. Not one person is listening. They don't have any way of knowing. Nobody knows that.
Oh, hi. I'm Jonah Mussolino, and I'm a Gallery of Players alumni. I was in Gypsy and Ragtime. Then I moved on to Bronxville and Broadway. Then I was in 2 tours, Les Mis and Falsettos. Then I returned back to Broadway, Carolina Change. And then we heard the bad news that we would have to leave the theater before 5 p.m. that day due to coronavirus. But we still made the best of it. This virus has impacted me in many ways. Really just because I can't really see my friends in person and FaceTime isn't the same. What I do to keep me sane is riding my bike and hanging out with my family and playing video games and online schooling, of course. Thank you so much, Gallery Players, for this opportunity, and everyone stay safe out there.
Round 3. Saturday morning. The sun is shining. The birds are singing. It's a glorious spring day in New York. I lock myself in the bathroom, grab my IKEA scissors, and get to work. Wait for it to dry. rainbow unicorn! That's that gray patch right there. Be well, everyone, and stay creative.
So Jerry asked me about something that I miss, and something that I definitely miss is tap dancing in a studio. But for now, while we're home, we will just have to do this. All right. Hopefully see you all soon. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.
Stay healthy, safe, and be someone's light. Thank you.
While other folks grow dizzy, I keep busy biding my time. Next year.